You're listening to Right and Wrong, right here on KTSTFM.com, the most politically incorrect talk show on internet radio today. I'm John Matthews, your host. Again, just want to thank you for tuning in tonight and listening to me, letting me into your head, and we're going to play around here a little bit more with it. I want to get into the next part of this segment, or the next segment of what we're talking about tonight, the association between Barack Obama and the governor of Illinois. And that's how the media is going to play this. And what I really wanted to kind of point out is what the media has done up to this point, so you can see the pattern of how these people operate and what they do. I'm going to go through a series of articles here and just kind of highlight just a couple of real quick things. On December 3rd, that's Wednesday, in USA Today, front page article written by Susan Page. It says, the title of the article is Poll, Obama Earning High Marks. And it says, President-elect Barack Obama gets soaring marks for his handling of the transition and his choices for the cabinet. A USA Today Gallup poll finds, even at a time the public is downbeat over the economy, more than three out of four Americans, including a majority of Republicans, approve the job Obama has done a full fart. And apparently they never talked to any conservatives. But anyway, broad-based support he'll need as he faces tough decisions ahead. So now they're looking here and they're saying, okay, first of all, it says here Americans are projecting their hopes for the new president. So we got the pipe dream. Okay, so the media comes out first with a pipe dream. Americans are approving of Obama. Now when the scandal hit just a couple days later, we got an article that comes out in Reuters by Deborah Charles. It says Obama's seen untouched by Illinois governor charges. And here what we're saying is we don't know at this point if Obama has anything. It says President-elect Barack Obama's decision to keep a distance from his state's governor, who was arrested on corruption charges on Tuesday, should enable him to escape becoming tainted by the scandal. So they're saying here, well, we hope that there's nothing wrong. He should be able to walk away from it because apparently he kept his distance. Now we turn right around a day after that and we've gone from should being able to stay away from scandal to he has. And this article is written by Sharon Cohen, Associated Press, on 12/10, which is a Wednesday, Day Without a Gay Day. And it says here, Obama avoids stain of Chicago's political scandal. So we go to, he's got high ratings, he should be able to avoid the scandal, and now he has avoided it, all in a matter of 72 hours. And it says that Obama has managed to remain mostly, but not entirely, untarnished by local political corruption. Some analysts and former legislative colleagues cite various reasons. His skill, brains, and character, which I think he has none. His reform-minded base and his path to power. And his path to power, which did not involve climbing through the ranks of the Chicago Democratic machine. What a bunch of BS. That's exactly what was his rise to power. It was through the Democratic machine, through the education system and the ties to all the people that are tied into the politics. Now, Don Rose, as a longtime political strategist, says, rather than being above the fray, I think he has sidestepped the fray. So we've gone from, he's a good guy, doing a good job, his transition's great, to we hope he avoids the scandal, to he has avoided it, all within 72 hours, and obviously nobody's done any investigation yet. Then, last and but not least, we get an article here in the LA Times, which just yesterday, and now they're spinning it saying Obama gets a crisis test run. So now it's a test. And it says, you know, three things. So first of all, his initial reaction, Obama said, oh, I'm sad about it, but he hadn't talked to Blagojevich at all. And he wouldn't discuss anything. On day two, he said that he wanted Blagojevich to resign. And then step three, finally the third day, he says he pledged to bring out more facts, which means we need to buy more time till we can figure out how to deal with the next crisis. So that's how the media is going to play it. He's back to being the Messiah. He's risen above the fray. In the most politically corrupt state in the Union, he's managed to sidestep it all. And just because he's such a purpose-driven and got such good intentions, he's a good guy. And we as a media have a lot at stake, and we can't in any way, shape, or form allow this guy to go down the toilet. And we will see how that plays out when it comes to the time when they can no longer deny it. Anyway, that's what I think about that. You can email me at youidiot@rockandmail.com. Got to go to another break here. We'll be right back. Stay with us. You're listening to KTSTFM.com 89.5.